Fox Sports Network. You're here watching OCAA women's basketball between your Humber Hawks and the visiting UTM Eagles. My name is Kyle Dalton. With me is my broadcast partner, Adam Lusher, and we have a good one for you today. The Humber Hawks are winners of 10 in a row. They've lost their first game of the year, but since then, they're on a 10-game win streak. The UTM Eagles, on the other hand, are in a different story. They won their first four games, but have lost their last eight. Humber made a little bit of adjustment at the front court of their starting lineup to begin the second half of the season, and it's paid dividends for them.
Yeah, even at 10-1, a great season thus far. AJ Sharma not getting complacent. You've seen Laura Meadows, now that she's healthy, checking into that lineup as a starter, and now even more depth as you have Jamie Gordon coming off the bench, which is a big add to that lineup. So far, so good for that experiment by head coach AJ Sharma.
You mentioned it, Jamie Gordon starting the year in the starting lineup for the Humber Hawks, now coming off the bench. Laura Meadows now in the starting lineup. She's been great coming into the starting lineup for the Hawks. And for more on tonight's game, we're sending over to Danielle on the sidelines.
And I'll be your sideline sports reporter for the duration of today's game. Today, the Humber women's basketball team are going up against the UTM Eagles, and it will hopefully be their 11th win of their regular season game. Now, our two key players we're going to want to look out for today are Maya Campbell-Johnson and as well as Laura Meadows. Those two have definitely been putting up the points lately, and they're the key players to look out for. And for more of our games, back to our commentators. Thank you.
Thanks, Danielle. And you mentioned it, Laura Meadows and Maya Campbell-Johnson being a factor in that front court. They've combined for 80 points and 34 rebounds in their last two games so far.
And that's just two games over the weekend. Quite the trip down south, knocking off the Lambden Lions and the St. Clair Saints. So these girls are coming in with a whole lot of momentum on their side. And you look at the opposite. We mentioned UTM on an 8-game losing streak. It might be quite the shootout tonight as the Hawks try to pull away.
And we have to give the fame to some other players as well. Leticia Lopez playing really well so far for the Hawks, and she's really stepped up in a huge role after the loss for the Hawks from CJ Nofuente.
Yeah, it's a huge gain, the play of Leticia Lopez this year. So far, 41 triples on the season, just 24 three-pointers away, from Noah Fuente's record of 65 for the 2016-17 season. She's been a key contributor.
Yeah, you can see her on the screen. Last game versus Lambton, 14 points, 3 of 6 from 3, so 50%. That's what you like to see from her. She's shooting 40% from 3 on the season, which actually leads the league in her fifth year on the Humber Hawks. Another good stat is Hawks are first in rebounds, so we should see another good rebounding game for the Hawks here, UTM in 12th. So we'll see if the Hawks can take care of the glass here tonight.
Yeah, a couple of good rebounding teams here. Should be interesting to see who gets the best of the boards here tonight.
So we're going to get the national anthems and starting lineups, and we'll be back shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the mess here at the Humber Athletic Center for this matchup between the UTM Eagles and your Humber Hawks. At this time, we would ask you to please stand, if you're able, for the playing of our national anthem. Starting lineups first for the UTM Eagles. A 5'5 guard of the London United Kingdom, number 2, Jade Adai. A 5'5 guard out of Milton, Ontario, number 6, Janela Viado. A 5'5 guard, a number 8, Trisha Bow. A 5'6 forward out of Mississauga, Ontario, number 14, Gianna Alajar. And a 5'11 forward out of Cambridge, Ontario, number 16, Elizabeth D'Souza. The head coach for the UTM Eagles is Saley Johnson Edwards. For this matchup, Rob Spatafora, Sean McManery, and Andy Zavantis. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the UTM Eagles and your Humber Hawks.
There. Nice to see her start this one on the floor. Let's see how she can contribute with this big lineup so far.
Her first start of the season in the Hawks control to start off this game. Lopez. Anna Jacobs getting her first start of the season, has the ball over to Lopez.
You get used to that sight all night. Leticia Lopez, definitely the general of this offense.
Janae Giles, a three. That's off the mark. Weak side rebound for Vaux. Back the other way. A die now to the rim, past Lopez. Can't finish though, rebound Lopez.
Jada Dye not able to finish there, but look out for that all night. She leads the UTM Eagles in scoring.
Yeah, she's second in the league in scoring. Anna Jacobs the three, that's good. And her first start of the season comes up big with a three.
Not a bad way to start it if you're Anna Jacobs, getting on the board early.
3-0 lead for the Hawks, a die. That's gonna be out of bounds, turnover here from the Eagles.
Yeah, a little sloppy on the handle there is Trisha Vaux as she lets that one drift off out of bounds.
Good start here for the Hawks defensively. Turnover from UTM. Here's Janae Giles.
That's the thing about this Hawks defense. You usually have to shoot from the perimeter. They're just too strong on the inside.
Janae Giles from the pass from Lopez goes strong and good take there from Janae Giles.
See there how fast she can break from beyond the arc to under the basket. Going to be hard pressed for these Eagles defense to keep up with Janae Giles all night long.
Fiatto working on Lopez. The three here from Vaux, that's deep, that's off the mark, rebound Giles. Looked like she got fouled, and the foul's going to go on Janela Fiatto.
Strong start by the Hawks. AJ Sharma has to be pleased with this. Plenty of energy coming out of the gates here, quick 4-0 lead.
Anna Jacobs, that shot earlier looked like a three. Call was her foot was on the line, so it was a long two for Anna Jacobs. Hawks lead 4-0 here early in this one. Lopez over to Giles at the top here. Fiatto on her, back to Anna Jacobs. Finds Lauren Meadows trying to go to work here. The swipe through, she's gonna call for the travel. And a turnover from the Hawks.
Lauren Meadows just plays such a tough version of basketball. It's hard not to foul her at some points. A very physical player. She'll wreak havoc for the Eagles all night.
And that's the duo you want to see from the Hawks. Go to work in this one with Laura Meadows and Maya Campbell Johnson.
Don't forget, if you had enough of those two, it's Jamie Gordon coming off the bench. So not much reprieve for these Eagles as they face the Hawks tonight, who are off to a good start.
Another turnover here from UTM. They almost got it back, stripped away there from Almajar, but the Hawks end up with the ball. Janae Giles at the top here, over to Lopez.
Hawks have been spreading the looks around. Be interested to see who takes this shot.
Lopez, crossover move, trying to go under the bucket, hits the bottom of the rim. Rebound for UTM, back the other way, trying to make the move. Here's Viado. She loses another turnover from UTM. Here's Janae Giles.
Common sight, trying to press the interior.
Lopez, the three. That's good. A wide open three, and she's not going to miss many of those.
42 on the season now for Leticia Lopez. She's had an amazing season from the three-point line.
She leads the league in three-point percentage and shows it off there. The guy gives it up here. We got Vaux. Good defense here from Anna Jacobs. Kept alive there, but Jacobs comes up with it. Here come the Hawks, transition basketball.
Jacobs showing exactly what she brings to this lineup.
Giles, the wide open three. That's good on the pass from Lopez. And we're going to get an early timeout here as a 10-0 run to start this game for the Hawks.
Doesn't get much better than that. If head coach J.J. Sharma knew about this in the locker room, I think he'd be pretty happy shutting out the Eagles.
Back-to-back threes there. We saw Lopez with one, and she gives it up to Janae Giles for another three. And that three ball coming into play for the Hawks, we were expecting a lot of threes, and so far we've seen it.
Early and often, the girls are raining down from beyond the arc, and an adjustment is definitely going to have to be made by Sally Johnson-Edwards, head coach of UTM. As time and time again, we see those Eagles trying to press in the paint and really drive and just unable to do so in this very strong defensive lineup.
Yeah, it's been a couple already, I think three or four turnovers already for the UTM Eagles. We're only a few minutes into this game. The Hawks, though, taking advantage of the mistakes from the UTM Eagles. So that was the first bucket from Anna Jacobs, the foot just on the line, or else that would have been another deep three for her.
Yeah, usually Anna Jacobs is more brought into games for her defensive ability, but showing off, she has quite the jump shot. Training that long too must be good for the confidence, getting start number one of her season.
Now she's only averaging 9 minutes per game. She's been in 10 of the 11 games so far this season in her first start. Usually McCabe Taylor is that one that starts for the Humber Hawks. Instead, head coach AJ Sharma elects to go with Anna Jacobs for tonight's game.
And that just showcases the depth of this squad. Plenty of players on that bench that would start on most teams, with only five allowed on the floor at the time.
Here's a die with it. Got to watch out for her if you're the Hawks. She can try to get her team back in this one. Over to Aljar.
Looking strong for defense.
1 second left on the shot clock. Have to put something up, and good defense from the Hawks.
If Anna Jacobs keeps up this defense, you can expect that 9 minutes per game average to rise. She's been all over the floor so far tonight.
Yeah, she's brought a lot of energy so far for this Hawks team. Here's Janae Giles.
Speaking of energy, Janae Giles, always fun to watch.
Campbell Johnson back to the top to Lauren Meadows. Pump fake there. Driving hard. Good take there. Can't finish. Rebound here. And Vaux comes down with it, but Meadows will get the foul, be outside out of bounds.
Yeah, you see Meadows there with that pump fake beyond the line. You'll see that time and time again, but usually just a method for her to drive that paint. Definitely more of an interior player, but given an open look, she has quite the jump shot as well.
Yeah, she has yet to make a three this season, only taking two. Not a real threat from three. Inside there, trying another turnover here from UTM, and here comes Humber. Janae Giles finds Lopez on the corner. Here's the three. That's off the mark. Rebound. UTM coming down the other way as a die. Going strong at Meadows, who stands right there. Rebound. UTM, they corral it here. 18 seconds left on the shot clock. A deep three from Vaux. That's off the mark. Rebound. Jacobs.
This defense absolutely swarming the Eagles, not giving any breathing room.
Tipped there from Madai. Meadows battling with it. It's pulled away here. Adai gets the pass, and it looks like it's going to be a foul there on Anna Jacobs, but you like that energy from her going after Adai in the loose ball.
Yeah, absolutely. Not the tightest of games right now at 10-0, but the girls running up and down the floor. You see Leticia Lopez chase down Jada Jai on that play. Energy is at a 10 so far.
Britannia Brown and Jamie Gordon will check in as Giles and Maya Campbell-Johnson check out for the Hawks. Kayla Rice checks in for UTM alongside Rooms for UTM.
AJ Sharma not afraid to go up and down his bench as You'll see plenty of players rotate into that one.
Big block there, yeah. Anna Jacobs on Rice. The deep three from Adai. That's off the mark. Here comes Lopez. Back the other way. Britannia Brown into the game. Meadows over to Anna Jacobs. Screen there from Laura Meadows.
Great ball movement.
Yeah, Lopez the three. That's good on a great pass from Anna Jacobs, but that was all set up from the screen from Laura Meadows.
Yeah, a lot of ball movement there. Seeing who has the open look, and Leticia Lopez drains that one.
Fiato here running the offense for UTM, looking for their first bucket of the game. A three here. That's good from Al Najjar, and the UTM Eagles are finally on the board with a three.
Trying to stop the bleeding, are the Eagles going to need a few more of those to try to draw back close into this one. Hawk shooters, very hot.
Turnover there from Meadows. Here's Viado back the other way for UTM. Viado still carrying it right now. Running this offense. Dishes it off. Rice, the jumper, that's no good. Rebound Jacobs over to Lopez.
And those are the high percentage shots that you're going to have to make against a strong Hawks team.
That turnover here from the Hawks is Lopez looking for Gordon on the run. She can't handle it. So we're going to get another few subs here. Janae Giles checked back in alongside Brittany English.
So expect this to happen all night long. Quick rotations from Sharma. Leticia Lopez and Laura Meadows get a much-deserved break.
Hawks lead 13-3. 13-0 run to start this game. UTM came back with a three from Al Najjar. Here's Viado for UTM.
Fiato's been active tonight, not able to get too much done.
There's Adai. She's been quiet so far in this one. Pressure, great defense here from Brittany English. Comes up with it. Back the other way. Sorry, that's Britannia Brown. Now it's Brittany English back the other way, and she finishes it with the bucket.
Still early in the first quarter, but you see what those fresh legs could do as English bolts down the court for that layup.
Great defense there from Britannia Brown on Adai. Another turnover from UTM. Here's Rice. Looking for the bank shot, no good. Rebound, no good. Comes up with it. Jamie Gordon battling down there with it as well. Hawks come up with the wall, with the ball with Brittany English now. Janae Giles back to English. Looking cross side to Britannia Brown. Finds Jamie Gordon at the elbow, the jumper, that's off the mark.
Hawks making it look easy so far. You see that ball movement there. Eagles have no answer for this Hawks offense.
Fiato now running this offense, trying to get her team back in this game.
She has to realize driving to the net is not working. Maybe a more perimeter game would be necessary.
Three here from Al Najjar. That's off the mark. She has the only point so far for UTM. Jamie Gordon running down the floor, gets the pass from Giles and finishes strong.
How about Giles like a quarterback on that one with the overhand heave from half court, finding Jamie Gordon wide open.
Jamie Gordon, as soon as that rebound came down, she was running down the floor, was wide open. Got UTM off guard. Here's Rice.
Hawks doing a great job of getting in the passing lanes.
Great defense right now. Jamie Gordon on Al Najjar. Rice now battling. Great defense there from Ebony Beals. Turnover here from UTM once again. Janae Giles.
Tania Brown, defensive stud so far.
Giles will settle it down here. Ebony Beals going up strong, looking for a foul, didn't get it. And it's going to be off of UTM and out of bounds as we're going to get a few subs here from UTM.
UTM trying to match those fresh legs. You'll see Jada Dye come out of the game. The Hawks did hold her to a season low 11 points the last time they met. So it seems as though they do have an answer for a Dye, and so far tonight, all things have been going well.
Still looking for a first point of this one. Jamie Gordon, Britannia Brown in the corner for English, the three. That's off the mark, rebound Gordon. That's good on the weak side, rebound with just 2 seconds left on that shot clock.
That's a tough play under the net. Gordon able to wrestle that ball away and put up an easy layup.
Hawks with their largest lead, it continues to grow. It is 16 right now, Hawks lead 19-3. Just over 2 minutes to go in the first. Vaux.
Eagles unable to get any sort of rhythm on offense.
Another great defensive play there. This time it's Britannia Brown as Mike Campbell-Johnson will check back into this game for Jamie Gordon.
Yeah, Trisha Vaux kind of shot up a prayer there with Britannia Brown all in her face, and that's been the story all night. Just not enough room to work for these Eagles. They have only drained one field goal so far tonight.
English Gets a screen from Campbell Johnson from the elbow. That one's good, and a good job by Brittany English to use that Maya Campbell screen.
Smooth little floater from the top of the key there, and MCJ, without touching the ball, makes her presence felt in this one.
Fiato DeVoe. Good defense there from Ebony Beals. Deep three from Vo. That's off the mark. Rebound Campbell Johnson. It goes off of her and out of bounds, so the Eagles will keep the ball.
Yeah, Janae Giles and MCJ were wrestling for that rebound. I don't think they knew they were going at each other. Ended up going off the hands of MCJ for an Eagles possession.
Anna Jacobs and Leticia Lopez will check back in for English and Giles. Rooms now. Stumbles there. Able to corral the ball. A deep three here. That's off the mark. Ebony Beals comes down with it. Oh, turnover here. She was looking for Lopez. A deep three. That's off the mark there from Viado, and Hawks catch a break.
Yeah, Ebony Beals got nothing more than an extra rebound on the stat sheet after that errant pass.
Campbell Johnson going up twice, and eventually she gets fouled, and she'll go to the line for two shots from the foul from Tasha Rooms.
MCJ, as we mentioned pregame, quite the road trip for her. She had 42 points and 23 rebounds in those two games against St. Clair and Lambden. The Hawks have not needed her too much tonight, but first opportunity to put points on the board.
And the Hawks have only given up 3 points in this one during their 10-game win streak, as Maya Campbell-Johnson makes the first one. They've only given up more than 65 points once, so that defense has been pretty solid so far this season, and it's showing in this game.
And a lot of talk goes to that defense, but the offense as well is clicking on all cylinders. They've scored 80-plus in four straight games, so it's going to take a lot more than a three-point first quarter to try to keep pace with this squad.
Hawks lead by 20 here, just over a minute to go. Here's Viado trying to go strong to the rim. Good defense there from Lopez. It's battled here. Looks like we're going to get a jump ball. And possession arrow pointed in the Hawks' way, so UTM will keep the ball here. 9 seconds left on the shot clock.
And not too many adjustments will be needed at the conclusion of quarter number one. Is everything going swimmingly for the Hawks here with a giant 20-point lead?
The defense has been solid from the Hawks so far. A lot of turnovers from UTM, and the Hawks have taken advantage of that on a couple fast break points as well.
Tania Brown and Anna Jacobs have kind of been the people to watch on defense.
Silva has to put up a shot. That's way off the mark, and we've seen some uncharacteristic shots here from UTM, a little bit low percentage there from Silva.
Yeah, you're starting to see that frustration coming through, knowing they don't have open shots, but really still trying to chuck up whatever they can, trying to get it to the rim, and just not a single shot has worked for them.
Trying to get back in this game for sure. Here's Britannia Brown. That's off the mark, just off the rim, and the Eagles come down with it on the weak side. Viado now brings it across the timeline. Looking for Rooms. Finds Vo, back to Rooms. Over Maya Campbell-Johnson, that's off the mark. Rebound, Jacobs. Great defense right now by the Hawks. 20 seconds to go in this one. 17 seconds on the shot clock. 4 second differential between the two.
You see them double-teaming Laura Meadows.
There it is, Vo comes up with it. She gives it up, but another turnover here from UTM. Jacobs comes up with it. 5 seconds left. Long pass, tip though, intercepted there from Viado. She puts up a three. That's off the mark, rebound, English. Excuse me, Britannia Brown comes down with it. And the Hawks, after a couple of awkward plays there in that final few seconds, still have a 23-3 lead after one.
Yeah, not much discussion going on the Hawks bench right now, and why would there be? They're off to a phenomenal start. 23-3 is the score, and they seem to be rolling on in this one.
And they really haven't had to use Laura Meadows and Maya Campbell-Johnson, that duo that we talked about in the pregame show. And it's really been that backcourt, I should say, from the Hawks that have really been the key factor so far in this one.
It's games like these when you can rest your big players like Maya Campbell-Johnson that really could pay dividends come playoff time. You think of those fresh legs, not as much wear and tear on the body. Sharma doing great work to cycle in each player and making sure everybody's healthy.
And AJ Sharma has done a great job so far this season containing the minutes of his players. Leticia Lopez is ranked 35th in minutes, and she's the only one in the top 35 for the Hawks, so it shows that he's using his whole bench.
Absolutely. A lot of star players on this team, but there is no number one option. You have 1A, 1B, 1C, 1D. You could go up and down that lineup. There are plenty of players where you have confidence with their ball in the hands in key moments.
It's that depth lineup. You mentioned it will come postseason time. The OCAA Provincials, that's going to come into a key factor when you have those fresh legs coming off the bench as well and starting. Girl like Laura Meadows, who did start the season. She had a little bit of an injury. She's come back strong, and it's definitely shown in the last couple games.
Yeah, I don't think anybody could have expected Meadows to kind of flourish in the lineup so quickly after coming back from that injury, but she's done just that, proving that she's up there as one of the most valuable players on this team. And obviously we've seen it. UTM time and time again with possessions have to double-team her, and that all credit goes to Meadows there drawing that attention.
In the last two games of the unofficial second half of the season, the Hawks have given up, their opponents have only scored 30% from the field, so it just shows that that defense continues to have success. And we saw it in that first half, or in the first quarter, I should say, as well. A lot of solid defensive plays from the Hawks.
And I don't have to look at the stat sheet to see that UTM Eagles, that percentage might be a little bit lower than 30% tonight. They're going to have to start looking for some really more percentage plays and be a lot more efficient from the field goal range.
Yeah, they only had one three-pointer made, and that was from Jana Elnajar from UTM. Meadows down low, gets open. Good pass there from English. Maya Campbell-Johnson gets it back, no good. There goes English right up and puts it in. What a play.
And how about the battle under the net there? English coming all the way in from beyond the arc to clean that up and put it away.
Brittany English, yeah, she came all the way from the top to snatch that rebound and put it right back up. Here's a die. She's got to get going for UTM. The pass there, another turnover from UTM. Here come the Hawks with Giles.
Yeah, you can't be forcing those passes in there if you're a die. Just too many Hawks in the paint.
Tip there. It looks like the foul's going to be on Vo.
The foul is on number
16 seconds left on that shot clock. Just beginning here in the second quarter. Hawks lead 25-3. Looking to keep the pressure on. Campbell-Johnson gets the pass from out of bounds there from Brittany English, and she'll get fouled and go to the line for two.
Every possession seems to be successful for the Hawks. They're either scoring a bucket or heading to the charity stripe. Not too much to critique thus far as Campbell-Johnson doing most of her work from the line.
She makes the first one there. No problem for Maya Campbell-Johnson, shooting 68% from the free throw line for the season.
The way the game's gone so far, expect her to get plenty of opportunities. She's proved to be unguardable along with her teammates Meadows.
They've only combined for 4 points in this one compared to 80 points in their last two games, but the Hawks still lead by 24. Adai now with it. Giles on her. She's looking in the post here, can't get it. Comes up with it, Vo the three. That's off the mark, rebound. Hawks trying to come up with it. Giles, a die battling, but it's gonna be a shot clock violation as that shot over there from Vo did not go off the rim.
It seems as though every loose ball so far tonight has gone in the hands of a Humber Hawk. Just the compete level seems to be higher, a little more hustle on the side of the home team.
That's gonna be an illegal screen here from Maya Campbell-Johnson as Lopez was coming around there.
Yeah, not the prettiest of screens we've ever seen from MCJ, but with this much breathing room, she's able to laugh that one off.
And Campbell-Johnson picks up her first foul of the game here. Esfiato will carry it for UTM. Lopez, good defense. Over to Vo. Inside here, Elnajar. She has the only bucket so far for UTM, a three here. That's off the market once again. Maya Campbell-Johnson comes down with it and finds Giles. Back the other way, finds English in the corner, just keeps it in, great play, finds Lopez, man down here for UTM. Meadows over to Giles, the three, went down looking for a call. Instead, it will be out of bounds, and the Hawks will retain the ball.
That seems to be the set play that's working for Sharma and the Hawks. They're working their way around the arc. Sino has the open shot, and time again, they're finding it, something the Eagles are unable to do.
Viada will check out. She's been good when it comes to leading that offense. Meadows the jumper, no good. Rebound, Giles, and puts it right back in. We talked about the rebounding being a factor here. A smaller UTM team, and the Hawks have taken advantage of that so far.
Yeah, the Eagles have two players with over 100 rebounds on the season, but unable to get anything going. The 6 foot Maya Campbell Johnson, she's not letting anything drop to the floor.
And that dynamic duo of Meadows and Maya Campbell Johnson playing a factor here so far when it comes to the glass. English far side to Giles, back to Lopez. Thought about the three, gives it up to Giles. She'll take the three, and that was good from when she shot it right in. 32-3, Hawks lead.
Yeah, that's a good call there. You can see off the fingertips that one was going in. Great stroke by Janae Giles.
Lopez thought about the three. She gave it up to her teammate.
Giles with a lead like this, why not be generous?
Here's Vo now. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Good defense here from English. What a job from Brittany English coming up with a defensive play.
Eagles seem rushed every time the ball's in their hands. Unable to get any sort of rhythm going. It's English again.
Giles thought about the three. Gives it up to Meadows. Good move there inside. But can't finish. Rebound Eagles.
A rare rebound from the Eagles. Is it able to slow this one down?
Here's Adai now with it. Still looking for her first point of the game, as many Eagles are. Only 3 points, which came in the first quarter. Put it up here, no good. Campbell Johnson comes down with it. Adai trying to battle turnover here from the Hawks. Campbell Johnson on Adai, big block there on Adai. Still battling here, and finally she'll go to the line, but what a defensive play from Campbell Johnson.
5 foot five, Jade Adai against 6 foot Maya Campbell Johnson. You can see there who won that battle. That's a tough play for Adai. She's doing the right thing. She's driving to the net. She's trying to kickstart this team, but just nothing going. The positioning of this defense is just too much to handle.
See Ebony Beals checking in alongside Evelyn Anang and Jamie Gordon. First one missed from Adai.
For Adai, it's just important to see a ball go through the basket right now. Looking to find her touch.
And she makes it 67% from the line on the season for Adai, as the Eagles finally get their first point of the quarter, 32-4. Here's Lopez. Over to Anang, just checking into the game. And it's gonna be a traveling call. Just held on to that ball for a slight second there. Anang gets called for the travel.
Yeah, nice move, nice quick move to the baseline there by Anang, but referee does call a travel.
Here's Adai. Going strong here with the right hand. That's off the mark. Rebound English.
And the one advantage this Eagles team might have is the athleticism of Adai. Trying to get the ball in her hands as much as possible as she seems to be having some success driving.
Anang finds Beals, back to Anang. Great cut there. Can't finish though. Here come the Eagles back the other way, but a great cut there from Anang.
Yeah, tic-tac-toe, but just wouldn't go. It's a pretty play, but no points on the board.
Three here off the mark. Rebound Hawks with Lopez. Finds Britannia Brown. Back to Lopez, looking far side. Anang,
wide
the three.
Open.
That's off the mark. Weak side rebound is going to bounce out, and UTM will get the ball. But that's what you want to see from first-year player Anang coming off the bench and putting up shots.
Yeah, she's been a little bit of a firecracker since coming off the bench. Run around the floor, having some nice looks. And this is a great opportunity with this type of lead for these depth players to come in and really make a presence felt.
She's played in 10 games so far this season, only averaging 6 minutes. I'm sure she'll see a lot of playing time in this one. Try to make an impact, trying to prove herself here. She'll get called for the foul.
And we've seen plenty of players rotate in so far tonight. And each and every one has done their job. There's been no dip in hustle, no dip in compete level. It's been a consistent night all night long for the squad.
Hawks lead 32-4, 5:34 left here in the first half. Good defense there from Gordon on the inbounds play. Here's Adai going inside. Jump ball here, great defense, grabbing that ball from Britannia Brown. UTM will keep the ball.
After that tumble, Adai taking a look at that taped up hand. Wonder how much that's a factor for her tonight, but she's doing everything she can, trying to be a one-woman show, but this defense is tough to penetrate.
It's going to be a violation foul here against Britannia Brown. That's her first foul, and we're going to get a timeout on the floor here with just over 5.5, or just under 5.5, I should say, 32-4 lead for the Hawks, and it's been all Hawks so far in this one.
Yeah, this one hasn't been close, not for a single second. The Hawks are absolutely running away with this one. And for the Eagles, it might be a little too late to find an answer with this first half almost concluding.
And it's been a couple of uncharacteristic plays from the Eagles with a couple turnovers. And they've really given the Hawks the opportunity to extend their lead, I should say, with a couple big possessions, a couple fast break points as well for the Hawks off of some key turnovers from UTM.
Yeah, time and time again, they're getting the rebound on the defensive side of the floor. That fast break has been unstoppable for the Eagles, as you've seen every player come in and work that fast break to perfection. A lot of great ball movement. They're hustling to the net after each and every shot. So far, a flawless performance. It's 32-4. What else can you say? The Hawks have been on a roll.
Yeah, you said a flawless performance so far, especially on the defensive end. Obviously, the offense is going to be there. 32 points so far through about half of the first half. But that defense has really been key so far. UTM, only 4 points.
And I've talked time and time again about that interior defense and just how hard it is to work into the paint against the Hawks. But it's been on the perimeter, too. You see Jamie Gordon here working hard and just not giving them a second to get a set play working.
A die now. Britannia Brown on her inside to Rice, working on Lopez. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. They got to put something up, and it's off Gordon and out of bounds. And there's that defense coming into play. Lopez going to work.
Yeah, it appears the Hawks know where the ball is going before the Eagles do, as they've been on the receiving end of plenty of Eagles passes.
Evelyn Anang will check out. Anna Jacobs checks back in. 3 seconds left on the shot clock. The Eagles going to have to put something up quick.
Someone's got to get open first.
It's Rooms now. She's got to put it up. She does. Doesn't touch the rim at all, but Lopez comes down with it.
Once again, you see how quick down the floor the Hawks get.
Anna Jacobs, those bright shoes, lost it for a second there, gets it back. Ebony Beals trying to go to work here, finds Lopez.
Jacobs wide open.
Now on the far side here. Calls for it. 1 second left on the shot clock. She's got to put it up. Doesn't go off the rim, and it's going to be a shot clock violation for UTM, but Anna Jacobs there was wide open for a second. I don't think Lopez saw her.
Yeah, I think Lopez was looking for her own look there, and Jacobs had her hand up on the perimeter. Not the greatest shot selection there, as she had to toss up a last second prayer, but those points aren't needed.
Adai carries it across the timeline here. 4:35 to go in the first half. Adai kicks it out. The jumper there off the mark from Rooms. Comes down with it is Lopez. Ebony Beals running the floor. Far side is Jacobs. This time Lopez finds her.
Good
Jacobs.
Court vision.
Yeah, there's the three. That's off the mark. Jacobs tracks
down
her own rebound.
How about the hustle by Jacobs? Flying by everybody. She gets her own rebound.
This time she will kick it to Lopez. 5 on the shot clock. Jacobs puts up the three. This time it's good. Anna Jacobs on the pass from Leticia Lopez.
And what a night for her. That's a name we've called time and time again. Anna Jacobs making sure that name is on the stat sheet.
Rooms trying to work on Beals here. Kicks it out off the official. Stays in there for a second. UTM will keep it. Adai, the three. That's off the mark. Rebound. Beals comes down with it strong.
But the Eagles are doing the only thing that's working. It's getting it into the hands of Adai and letting her create a play.
Lopez slows it down to Jacobs, over to Britannia Brown, back to Beals inside. A great pass to Gordon, goes up.
Here.
And the foul is actually going to go the other way.
A couple nice plays there. Britannia Brown had a wide open look at that three, but she knew Ebony Beals was open down low. And how about that wraparound pass to Jamie Gordon under the net?
That was a great pass there. And that's what you want to see with this big lead. You want to see that ball movement from the Hawks. And we've seen that. We saw that on that possession in full display.
Yeah, I don't imagine they're going to be as heavy with the three-pointers after this lead is bloated now. But nice ball movement inside, and look at Jamie Gordon and others to capitalize.
UTM trying to go to work here, trying to get a bucket. Great play there from Britannia Brown, pushing that one across. 4 seconds left on the shot clock. They just got to put up a shot. It actually does go off the rim. Rebound Hawks, though. They come down with it. Deep three there, but that was just touched the rim with under 3 seconds to go on the shot clock.
Nice pick there by Ebony Beals.
Jacobs the three. That's good. She's money. 2 of 2. Her last two shots from three.
She's red hot, just like those shoes she's wearing. It's been a strong night for her.
spreading up the floor. Good defense there from Brown, but she'll get called for the foul. 15 seconds left on the shot clock as Brown picks up her first foul.
AJ Sharma still finding coaching opportunities no matter what this lead is, making sure the positioning and his defense is just the way he likes it.
Almajar with it now. Good defense here from Gordon. Deep three here, that's off the mark. Gordon with the rebound. And the Hawks come down with it. They lead 38-4, just under 2:30 to go. Here's English.
Staying busy on the offensive side of the ball.
Jacobs, good power move there, but she'll get charged for the foul. She was going for the rip through there.
Yeah, she has a smile on her face. She knows what she just did and tried to poke the ball away. Did the Eagles and forcing a travel on Jacobs.
Yeah, she had that help defense there. Come on her from Viado. Looking for Jamie Gorn at the top.
Interesting to see Britannia Brown still pressing that inbound. I'm sure something instructed to her by Sharma.
UTM, 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Good defense here from the Hawks. Great defense. Anna Jacobs there, and Beals comes down with it. English, she'll carry the ball across the timeline here. Over to Jacobs, trying to go up. That's no good, rebound tipped away, and Jacobs will get called for the foul here over the top.
Had the right idea as she swatted that rebound away to the perimeter, but foul called, and it may be a little too early to toss in the ballot for player of the game, but Anna Jacobs sure making her name heard.
Her and Britannia Brown have really been key factors on the defensive side, have brought a lot of energy on that second unit, or I should say Anna Jacobs. She started this game for the first time this season.
And that just shows the work ethic of this team. It doesn't matter if it's a tie game or a lead such as this, 34 points as it stands now. Every single play is hustle and heart from this team, and those are two traits they're going to try to carry into the second half of the season.
Elizabeth D'Souza on the line. The Hawks are in the penalty. She misses both. And this time it's going to be a foul against the UTM Eagles on Almajar.
Almajar's throwing some hard out there, working hard, but it's been a long night for her. She is the Eagles' leading scorer, but her stats stand at just 3 points.
Beals. 1:30 to go in this one. Here's Anna Jacobs. Back to English. Good pass there to Gordon inside. She can't finish. Rebound comes down. And here come the Eagles with Viado. Over to Almajar.
You see on the transition how each Hawk latches on to an offensive player.
Silva the three. That's off the mark. Anna Jacobs will let this one go out. Off the air ball from Victoria Silva.
Give a lot of credit to Anang there, getting right in the face on that three ball. That results in an air ball, as we've seen time and time again.
Here's English. She's running this offense here. Second unit on the floor.
Been very impressed with English so far and her calmness and patience with the ball in her hands.
6 points for the Hawks. She's passing the ball really well, and this time Jamie Gordon able to finish on the pass from English.
Beautiful touch on that pass from English, and Jamie Gordon doing what she does best, cleaning things up under the rim.
Hawks lead 40-4. 45 seconds to go. Great defense there from Beals on D'Souza. Beals will bring it up over to Jacobs. She goes strong, looked like a foul. And that's going to be the call. And Jacobs going strong to the rim. That's what you want to see.
Yeah, she's been doing it all night long. And if they're not going to stop you, why wouldn't you keep doing it? And she's been successful time and time again. And any adjustments made by Sally Johnson-Edwards would pay some dividends here, as 36 points so far is the lead.
Fourth team foul on the UTM Eagles. And Anang misses. English goes up strong. And a good finish. She has 8 on this one.
That's just too easy for English. You see her with that inbound and trots out right under the basket without being picked up by a defender. These easy points to the Hawks aren't doing any favors.
Viado going up, couldn't get under. Rebound Almajar. Oh, there's that block from behind from Jacobs.
Jacobs showing no mercy.
And Almajar adds a point for UTM, their first field goal of the quarter. She's got 5.
Hawks trying to answer quickly with that fast break. Here's Jacobs.
Beals. And I don't think Jacobs knew how much time was left. But all in all, the Hawks have dominated this game 42-6 after the first half.
Yeah, not much of a storyline here. It's been a steamrolling. As you look at those numbers there, the Hawks again on pace to score 80-plus for their fifth straight game. But really just, it's not needed. Those 80 points sure look great on the stat sheet, sure look good, but with the defense being as suffocating and as dominating as it has been, I mean, they could have had 10 points on the board and carry in a halftime lead.
And we mentioned about Maya Campbell-Johnson, Laura Meadows being factors, and really they haven't been factors. It's been that defense of Britannia Brown and Anna Jacobs that really have been the story so far in the first half.
Yeah, MCJ and Meadows, both competitors. I'm sure they'd love to be on the floor, but they're fine with sitting this one out. The girls have took care of business.
So the Hawks lead 42-6 at the end of the first half. We'll take a break and be back for second half action after this.
points over UTM, and really it's been a dominant performance so far from the Humber Hawks on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if it's offensive or defensive play. The Hawks have ran roughshod over the UTM Eagles all night long. And unfortunately, basketball isn't one of the varsity games or sports to include a mercy rule, so we're going to have to play out this second half here, but it's going to take the miracle of all miracles for these Eagles to claw back in this one.
And it'll be interesting to see how the Eagles do come out of that rough first half. Obviously not ideal play on the road. We'll see what type of energy they have coming out of that rough first half here, committing 12 turnovers and the Hawks scoring 16 points off those turnovers in that first half.
Yeah, stats don't always tell the whole story, but if a team shoots 5.4% from the field in the first half, that's pretty representative of the night they've had so far.
Hawks have their starters on the floor to begin this second half. Here's Lopez now with it.
Wouldn't expect this starting five to be out there too long. Sharma's showing time and time again he wants to get fresh legs on the floor.
Janae Giles, that's off the mark. She leads her team with 10 points in that first half. Here's Adai, still looking for her first field goal of the game.
She had a season low of 11 points last time out against Humber, just one on the board so far tonight.
And there's a turnover once again from the Eagles. Anna Jacobs with it now. Pass there, a little miscommunication between Herd Meadows, turnover from the Hawks. Here's Viado.
Viado really trying to lead this offense, but unable to find the passing lane she needs.
D'Souza kicks out to Adai, the three, that's off the mark. And the Eagles have been shooting up the three, 1 of 16 in that first half. They missed their first one of the second half.
More of the same out the gate for the UTM Eagles.
And Brittany English already set to check in. Here's Giles, the three, that's off the mark, weak side rebound. Laura Meadows trying to come up with it. Lopez will eventually grab the ball. Here's Lopez now. Gets a screen from Meadows, and that little shove at the last second there from Meadows, she gets called for it on the blocking foul.
Yeah, Leticia trying to drive to the basket there, but Meadows gets called for that screen.
That slight movement at the end there, a little shove at the last second there. Referee all over that one. 42-6 is the score here. 8:45 to go, just underway in this third quarter.
Yeah, definitely the intensity may have dropped a little bit from that first half. You've seen the Hawks flying around the court, a little more ease in their game so far.
That's off the mark there from Alnajar. She has 5 points, which leads her team. Here's Campbell Johnson with the shot, the floater, it's good. Maya Campbell Johnson. Hawks on the board here in the second half.
Just too easy for MCJ. She'll make that shot 99 times out of 100.
Campbell Johnson hasn't had much work in this one. She hasn't been needed. Only 4 points, make it 6 after that bucket. Here's Giles off the turnover with the free bucket, and she'll put it up and in. Janae Giles.
Smooth as can be as she ripped the ball out of the hands of that Eagle there and floated one soft.
Viado to Adai now. Adai, good move on Giles there. The crossover and the jumper, that's off the mark. Tipped away there from Leticia Lopez. There was Alnajar.
Adai has really showcased that talent tonight. Great handles, great speed, but still just none of these shots are dropping for her. Hasn't been an ideal night for the leading scorer of UTM.
And UTM will retain the ball here. Alnajar on the inbound there from Viado. Lopez on her. Viado going strong to the rim, knocks off the mark. Lopez with the rebound. We've seen a few opportunities here from UTM. They're just not, the bucket's just not dropping in for them here today.
Yeah, whether it's luck, whether it's play, just nothing's working. No adjustments made have been successful. It's going to be a long night if this keeps up.
Seen a couple times here they've gone to the rim instead of electing for that three like we saw a lot of times in that first half. There's Adai finally getting her field goal, and we've seen a couple times, like I just mentioned, these Eagles front court going to the rim.
Absolutely, and for Adai, why not with this type of lead and this deficit, drive hard and just try to make some creative plays. This game likely out of reach, but why not get a little momentum on their side?
And Meadows is going to get called for another illegal screen. That's going to be her third, so she's going to check out of this one. Jamie Gordon is going to check in. Two quick fouls here from Meadows.
What a duo that we've seen. Laura Meadows high-fiving Jamie Gordon as she comes to the game. both front court players. Very hard to defend under the basket.
And yeah, Meadows has been quiet in this one. And just like that, the Eagles get back the foul. So the foul is going to go to number 16, Elizabeth D'Souza.
And it's a pretty good night to be a Hawks fan. It's not too much reason to make a whole lot of noise tonight, as this one was out of hand early. But a nice crowd on hand, and I'm sure it'll grow for the men's contest later on tonight.
Of course, the men's game is right after this one, scheduled for 8 o'clock against the UTM Eagles. The men's team 11-0 on the season, sit in first place in the OCAA. As the Hawks can't put a bucket up here, and UTM will retain the ball.
Seems like all the energy has left the Hawks' nest after that electric start.
It was a quick start from the Hawks, put up a lot of points. Began the game on a 18-3 run. Kept going from there. Shot there off the mark. Campbell Johnson comes down with the rebound. Stripped away there from Elnajar. But the Hawks will get the ball back.
Yeah, nice hustle there from Elnajar, poking that away from MCJ, but the Hawks will retain possession.
Ebony Beals checks in for Campbell Johnson.
You got to think, this strong showing here tonight, it's all just a warm-up for that big game coming on Sunday, as the number 12-ranked Humber Hawks will take on the number 2 nationally-ranked Fanshawe Falcons. That should be a doozy of a game.
Yeah, that's going to be a great one on Sunday afternoon. That's scheduled for 1 o'clock. English goes up to the rim, and she'll get fouled.
Look at the handles on Brittany English, having fun out there. She works her way around that Eagles defender. And the girls sure look ready for Fanshawe on Sunday. It's been hard to point out mistakes they've made today.
And the Hawks, we talked about this Fanshawe game. That was the game, the first game of the year they picked up the loss, which ended their 81-game win streak against the OCAA in a 79-51 loss versus Fanshawe. That was at Fanshawe to begin the season. And since then, they've been on a roll with a 10-game win streak. So that Fanshawe game is going to be a big redemption factor for them.
Absolutely, just to see who's really on top. Currently tied at number one. Both teams sit 10-1 on the year. And Fanshawe's one loss did come to St. Clair. That's a team that the Hawks just handled pretty easily on the road this past weekend. So see what the momentum brings into that game. And Sunday should be a tight one.
Yeah, it's going to be a great one. We have a pretty good one here. Two Hawks all over UTM right now, 48-8. As it's going to be a foul here against UTM.
The Hawks lead now at 40. That eclipses the lead they had at the end of the second quarter, that lead of 38, so the biggest lead of the night. And this one seems insurmountable.
Britannia Brown trying to go to work here. She'll get fouled going hard, but she gave it up, so it'll be an outside out of bounds foul. 14 on the shot clock.
With the fans witnessing that this game's all but wrapped up, it seems the attention's turning to the popcorn stand.
Lopez, the three, that's good. Leticia Lopez from three, and that one was deep.
Digging the hole just a little bit deeper is Leticia Lopez. She adds to her phenomenal three-point numbers on the season.
She's got 9 points in this one. Adai now kicks it up to Rooms, the jumper. That's off the mark. Lopez comes down with the rebound.
A decent look there for the Eagles, but once again, unable to convert.
Beals now.
Not finding too many high-efficiency shots.
Unable to get the rebound. There was the Hawks on the weak side. Adai comes up with it. Adai. Brown on her. Adai stops, puts it up, no good. Rebound, Elnajar comes in and can't finish it. We talked about those mistakes from UTM, unable to capitalize as Brittany English gets tripped up there from Ajay.
Yeah, English trying to juke her way around a die there, and looked like a little knee-on-knee contact. Going hard to the floor is English, but she seems no worse for wear, stretching out that wrist.
Everyone seems to be all right as English will go to the line as the Eagles are in the penalty here with 4:50 to go in the third.
And this is not a game in which you want to get injured with it already out of hand. And head coach AJ Sharma seems to realize that as plenty of fresh faces have checked in and out to this one.
Evelyn Ang checking back in.
English, just a 50% shooter from the floor. She missed attempt number one. Made number two, Goody. So that average ain't going nowhere, staying at 500.
One of two from the line is English. Here's a die back the other way. Fast break here, no good. Rebound, a die. Excuse me. Back the other way, that's no good.
Anang with a nice fast break.
Anang, trying to think of Evelyn Anang there for a second. Good play by her to grab that rebound and go down the floor.
Yeah, Anang's so fast on the floor, she doesn't really give it time to know who it is. She's a blur going down. One of those players that contributes a lot of speed into this lineup.
Adai.
When it comes to guarding players like Jade Adai, it's the speed that can really be a huge factor.
Adai now with it. Five on the shot clock. Good defense there from Brown. And Adai unable to keep it in as the Hawks will get the ball back up 52-8.
You can make a pretty extensive defensive highlight reel from the play of Britannia Brown tonight as she's been a thorn in the side of each and every Eagle.
Her and Anna Jacobs, who right now is on the bench, have been pretty solid on the defensive side. English over to Brown, the jumper, that's good. Britannia Brown, that's the bucket.
How about the assist there from English? I've really been impressed with her ability to distribute the ball.
UTM trying to get something going here. Maybe a three, that's off the mark. Bryce battling for it. Bryce now with it, gives it up. Elnajar trying to find a dive, but great defense there from Brown, who finds English. English gives it up to Gordon. Great pass and an easy finish for Jamie Gordon. We're going to get a timeout on the floor from the Eagles.
So we were wondering, coming out of halftime, were the Eagles going to right these wrongs and sure up that play? And the answer might be no, as they have had nothing going. And this third quarter, just 8 points on the board.
And a great pass here. English gives it up to Gordon, who gets the easy bucket.
That's a selfless play there by Brittany English, as she's shown the ability to stack up those assists tonight. With this type of lead, no need to chuck up shots and raise that score. So nice to see that the team is working on ball movement, much to the delight of Sharma, I'm sure.
Hawks lead 56-8 is the score. Just over 3.5 to go here in the third. Head coach Sally Johnson Edwards trying to get her team back in this one. Trying to grab some momentum that maybe her team can carry over into the next games.
Yeah, I don't think she expects a W coming out of the Hawks nest tonight, but at the very least, you gain some of that momentum. It looks as though they're going to be working their way towards a 9-game losing streak. And it's going to take a mighty performance in their next game to right the ship and try to get a W in the column.
And UTM is right now is on a 3-game road trip beginning here today against Humber. They'll go to St. Clair, which is also a tough opponent, and Lambton also not an easy one as well. So they do have a tough schedule coming into this one. So it's not going to get any easier for UTM.
And it's been quite the drop-off. UTM came out of the gates winning their first 4 games of the season, and now looks as though they'll drop 9 straight. So the roller coaster ride of a season continues for these UTM Eagles.
So trying to get out of that slump and try to get the ball rolling on a couple victories here for UTM.
There's been very few bright spots, and you can see why that streak is extended. Coming up on 9 now, a lot of missed shots, a lot of unforced errors. Those high efficient shots that really should be going down just aren't tonight.
And you saw one right there, looked like a layup, and turnover here from the Hawks. But we've seen, you mentioned a couple of bright spots from UTM. They're just unable to capitalize on a couple key opportunities that maybe have tried to keep them in this game. And the uncharacteristic turnover here from the Eagles. A little bit of confusion there.
Yeah, speaking of unforced errors, even the rebounds, or sorry, the inbounds aren't going away to the Eagles as they're struggling in every facet of the court.
So the Eagles get the ball right back to Humber here. 3:06 to go in the third. English over to Beals. Back to Brown now. Back to English, finds Jamie Gordon.
Hawks done a great job all night, find an open court.
Good screen there from Gordon. Brown unable to finish. But back here, Anang has it now stripped away. And UTM comes up with it, and a big foul there. This time it's gonna go on Britannia Brown on Viado.
Yeah, it's a bit of a tough play there for Brown, as it appears the Eagles player just ran directly into her, but will draw the foul. foul number two.
See Viado there, still looking for first points of the game. She's been good carrying that offense and running the ball.
Yeah, she's been very active, just has not had an answer for Britannia Brown.
Deep three here, that's off the mark, rebound. UTM comes down with it, but it's turned over once again. This time, English comes around with it. English, pump fake there, great play to Brown.
Look at English there, finding that seam with that bounce pass. Throwing it time and time again tonight, she's been creative.
Brown with a little pump fake, caught the defense off guard. Unable to find Britannia Brown for the easy bucket. And a foul here against UTM, or excuse me, against Humber. It's gonna go on Ebony Beals.
And that lead continues to grow, which once was 40, now climbs to 50. But the Eagles are just tempted to get into double digits.
Good play there from Jamie Gordon. Another turnover from UTM.
Brown taking her time.
Nang now going strong, trying to find Gordon. Almost turned over there. The Hawks come up with it. English with 5 seconds on the shot clock puts up a shot. That's off the mark. Rebound Rice. And Hawks ball. Looked like that might have went off UTM. Instead, looks like it's going to be UTM ball.
Back in the game come MCJ and Anna Jacobs. So no time to rest for these Eagles as a couple strong players check back into this one.
Gordon and Brown check out for the Hawks. And we're going to traveling call here against Viado.
Been a rough night for Viado. She's done all she can. Working hard out there. There's nothing doing. It's been an uncharacteristic night for MCJ as she's really not been needed.
And this time she'll get called for the illegal screen. But you mentioned it, she hasn't really been needed so far in this game. Her and Laura Meadows, we mentioned at the top of the show of how a factor they were gonna be in this one. And really it's been that backcourt of the Hawks that have really, and the defensive play of the Hawks have really taken over this game. Here's Viado, the three. That's no good, rebound Beals, finds Campbell Johnson over to English.
And the Eagles have much better shot selection here in the second half, but just none of these shots are dropping. Doing a better job at finding open looks, but can't sink anything.
Anang the three, that's off the mark. Campbell Johnson comes up with the rebound, puts it up and in. And there's that rebounding ability from Campbell Johnson coming into play.
MCJ just added to the stat sheet. Ebony Beals continuing her strong defensive night.
Great defense there from Beals, and she comes up with the rebound.
Beals still good at rebounding. Shorty Millett, Anna Jacobs get a hold of that one.
Campbell Johnson, what a pass there from Brittany English. Picks up the assist by Campbell Johnson with the point.
Great work by MCJ to work her way to the rim there, find an open court, and English once again dropping dimes.
Viado, Rooms now with it. Rooms going hard to the rim. And finishes.
And that is double digits for the Eagles now as they reach 10 points.
Tayshia Rooms with the bucket. Shot clock is away here, 12 seconds left. English driving hard and she's gonna get fouled. Looks like Viado will pick up that one.
3-on-1 and it's Brittany English who ends up drawing the foul.
And Viado will pick up the foul. That's her fourth of the game, so she's one away from being out of this game. Doesn't look like she's going to check out here anytime soon, as Jada Dye is getting some work on the sidelines here.
Yeah, Jada Dye definitely been the most active Eagle, as she's had a lot of tough drives against this strong interior defense.
Looks like she got some work on her back. During this third quarter, we haven't seen much of her in this quarter, that's most likely why. Here's Viado, put up a shot here, trying to put something up before the end of the quarter, unable to. At the end of three, the Hawks lead 64-10.
What a score. I don't think we've seen anything quite like this so far in the season. I know earlier in the year, the girls kept Niagara to, I believe, 28 points, but looks as though they're going to beat that mark tonight. Is after three, just 10 points allowed by this Hawks defense.
This Hawks defense has been the story so far in this game, only giving up 10 points, as you can see on your screen, and it's really been the key contributors off the bench. Britannia Brown has been excellent on the defensive side. We saw Brittany English as well coming out in that second quarter, and it's really been that spark plug off the bench on the defensive side.
With how strong this team is, this lineup is, it's difficult for some of these players to get the playing time that they would maybe on a lesser team, but it's nights like tonight where they really have their opportunity under the spotlight, and they've taken that opportunity and ran with it with this 54-point lead. Great night for the bench and a great night overall for the Humber Hawks women's basketball team.
64-10, Hawks lead. The men's game will be coming up right after this one, Hawks versus UTM. Humber looks to keep their undefeated season alive at 11-0, sitting in first place in the OCAA, and they've been off to a hot start, so that should be another great one as well.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what the score is, that men's basketball team is so much fun to watch. Always brings a nice electricity to the gym. One name to look out for, Jimmy Rich. He's one of my favorites to watch. He's had some two-handed slams that has brought the gym to their feet.
Jimmy Rich, he's a good baller. Jalen Morgan as well. He's been a key factor in his first season on the team.
Yeah, the list goes on and on. Great team to watch. I know I'm going to be sticking around to check out that game, and I know we'll have you and the fine Matt Hamill on the call for that one.
That should be a good one. I'm excited for it. We still have a quarter left in this one. We'll see how the women's team for the Hawks come out and finish off this one, if they let up a little bit or if they keep the pedal to the metal and try to put away this Eagles team.
Yeah, hopefully they put an end to this game mercifully. And it's been a rough night for the Eagles, and I'm sure the Hawks will make it a little bit rougher in quarter number four.
We start the fourth quarter.
As if the Hawks needed to start with possession, they will here.
Here's English now carrying the ball, finds Beals at the free throw line. That's no good. Campbell Johnson stripped away there. Come down with it is Anduar, and she comes with it.
MCJ, not easy to rip the ball away from her. That's a nice play.
Viado going strong to the rim, and she'll get fouled from Jacobs.
Just in the opening moments of this fourth quarter, you see the energy pick up a little bit. Pass break there by UTM, and it'll give them a chance at the charity stripe.
Instead, the foul is actually going to go on Ebony Beals, who didn't like the call. Missed there from Viado. Still looking for first point of the game, and she gets it on that one. 64-11, here come the Hawks.
Brittany English, he's been strong all day long at finding open Hawks.
Trying to find Beals inside on the cut, can't do it. Turnover from the Hawks, UTM get the ball.
See this defense non-relenting, everybody latching on to their player. Even with, despite this score, the Hawks will not make it easy down the stretch.
That's what you want to see. You see these players maybe don't get as much playing time as they would see today. But they're playing with a lot of energy. Brittany English as well. Good pass there. Quarterback throw all the way to Maya Campbell-Johnson for the bucket.
Yeah, a little Patrick Mahomes deep ball there by Brittany English. She sends that one all the way down the court to MCJ.
UTM here trying to get a bucket.
Ball movement has been there. It's just trying to find those open looks.
Good move there. That one, Jody Halabi. Can't finish, though. Here come the Hawks. Good move there from English. Gets double team. Finds Jacobs. Looks for the shot. Kicks it out to English. She puts up a three. That's off the mark. Rebound Campbell Johnson. Just stays in bounds to English. 3 seconds on the shot. She's got to put it up. No good. Beals tops it. There's Campbell Johnson.
English had such a strong night with the assist, but not getting any of these deep balls to drop for.
There's English once again trying to find Beals, who puts it up. No good. Rebound. And Beals going to get called for the foul here. Has a couple missed shots there from the Hawks, and eventually Beals comes up with the foul.
Yeah, luckily those missed shots won't hurt you with the lead out as it is, but when you look forward to that Fanshawe game, they're going to have to take advantage of every opportunity. See Jada Jai check back into this one.
Yeah, four Eagles players coming on the floor. The only one staying was Viado. She's trying to get away there from English. Now does finds Adai. Adai makes a move on Brown. Goes up strong with the left hand. No good. Campbell Johnson tipped away from Adai. And Adai comes up with a good pressure here from Jada Dye. Three there from Viado. That's good. And she makes her first field goal of the game. And a good play there from Adai to come up with that loose ball.
Yeah, it didn't take long for Adai to show her importance into the lineup. As her athleticism and her quick cuts, as we'll see on this replay, able to find that open player in Viado who drains a nice three-pointer.
That's going to be a foul here against Humber. So UTM gets the ball. 66-14, 7:30 to go here in the fourth quarter. It's been all Hawks in this one since the very beginning. UTM at times have maybe felt like they could come back in this one, but the Hawks have really pulled away from them since that first quarter.
Yeah, if the Eagles had any idea at any point in this one that they had a chance, the Hawks sure made sure that they were aware that this game was all theirs. And they're tough as usual on home court, but tonight was a whole new ball game as there's been nothing going for the Eagles.
Hawks 4-0 at home this season. Have played more games on the road, 6-1 on the road so far. Their only loss coming, of course, in that first game of the season against Fanshawe, like we were mentioning a bit earlier.
And if you need to know just how strong the Humber Hawks are on home court, they've won 45 consecutive home games here at the Hawks Nest, and I think it's safe to say that'll shoot up to 46 in 6 minutes and 52 seconds.
Anna Jacobs gets charged on the foul here. That's her third. And UTM coming into this one at home 2-5 and on the road 2-3, so they played more road games, or I should say more home games, and now they have this three-game road trip starting here against Humber and then St. Clair and then Lambton.
Yeah, working their way south are UTM, and I mean the Hawks just came away with two wins against Lambton and St. Clair, but those are two quality basketball teams, and if the UTM Eagles trying to shake this big losing streak they're on, they're going to be hard-pressed to do so in Southern Ontario.
That's always a tough trip going down there. Hawks just did that trip and won both games, so it was a good way to start off the second half of the season. English tips it away. Jacobs finds English, finds back to Gordon, goes up strong and finishes. 68-15, 6:30 to go.
See the replay here. English distributing that basketball to Gordon, and she'll clean up the mess.
And a bucket there for Rice, UTM.
Yeah, I've been so impressed with Brittany English and her patience with the ball. Never seems to panic. Time and time again, finding that open player.
Foul there on Vo. But English playing in a much bigger role in this game, and that confidence definitely grown so far in this one.
And for AJ Sharma, that sure is nice to see, knowing that he could add these depth players for the lineup and them to contribute the way that they are tonight. Sure is reassuring as this regular season winds to an end here in 2019.
And a player like Brittany English, he's going to be key when it comes playoff time for sure. When you go deep into that rotation, as a steal there from Viado, and she'll finish. She didn't have a field goal coming into this quarter. Now she's got a couple to go along with that one.
Took her a little while to find her rhythm. Able to do so as she's adding up that point total, but a little too late.
Ebony Beals off the mark. Rebound Rice. Finds a die going on Anang. That's no good. Rebound Beals comes down with it.
Anang took a great angle at a die there, cutting her off from the rim, showing how strong defensively she is. Wide
Anang,
open look.
The three. No good. Rebound Viado back the other way. Finds a die. It goes up and good. That drops in. We're going to get a timeout here from AJ Sharma, not liking what his team is doing right now here in the fourth.
Yeah, Eagles going on their first, I guess, a mini run, you would call it at this point. And that's the first time tonight we've seen Adai able to get back behind the Hawks defenders as she drops that layup there. And You got to wonder how much of it the Hawks kind of taking off that gas pedal just a tad, or how much is it the Eagles improving their gameplay?
Eagles taking advantage of some turnovers here from the Hawks in this one, and that's really been the story in the first three quarters. We saw a lot of turnovers from UTM. The Hawks able to take advantage of that. And in this quarter right now, it's been the UTM Eagles that have really taken advantage of the turnovers from the Hawks.
Yeah, you got to give them credit. I mean, they were beaten to a pulp for three quarters straight, if we're being totally honest, and still came out here in quarter number four and putting up a good effort. They're showing they can hang with this team despite what the scoreboard says.
And we talked about how a good fourth quarter from UTM could maybe lead into a good start in their next game in a tough road trip like we were talking about earlier against St. Clair and then Lambton. So for head coach Sally Johnson-Edwards, you have to think, well, maybe I can get a little bit of momentum here for my team and carry it over into the next game.
Yeah, on that bus ride down to Southern Ontario, down to St. Clair, they're going to be thinking about this one. It's probably going to leave a sour taste in their mouth, but a strong fourth quarter here may lift the spirits just a tad as they go on that all-important Southern road trip to try to keep their season alive.
Edang now with it here for the Hawks. 5 minutes to go. English the shot, but it's going to be a foul here on Jamie Gordon on the push.
It's hard to call it foul trouble with a lead like this.
Three there, blocked from Anang. Great defense. Beals comes down with it. With Al-Najjar all over her, gives it up to English. Anang. Back to English, over to Jacobs in the corner now. Pump fake. 7 seconds left. Anang puts it up. That spills out. Beals comes down with the rebound. Loses it for a second, gets it back. Trying to bank it off a UTM player, but can't do that, and Eagles come up with it.
Ebony Beals, usually a real sure-handed rebounder, but kind of fumbled with that one there as it rolled through her legs.
Viato, the three, looking for the bank shot, no good. Adai with the rebound, puts up the left hand, and in. Jade Adai.
It's taken her a while, but finally finding the seams of this defense is Adai, as she's finally starting to get her game going.
Yeah, she's got seven on this one.
See how quick she darts around Ebony Beals there. Once again, she's at it.
Adai going strong to the rim, and she'll get fouled and go to the line. She was getting treatment on her back early in that third quarter, and she's played really well so far in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, whatever that trainer did, the magic touch of Jade Adai really came on strong in this fourth quarter. Right in the wrong she had early on in this one. A little too late to pull anywhere near a win, but just getting those baskets to drop sure must be nice.
Die, that one's good. She's got eight in this one, which leads her team now.
Yeah, she averages 19.3 a game, and we've mentioned time and time again that she had that low of 11 last time against Humber, so the Hawks really showing a proficiency to stop Jada Die in that high-powered attack.
Here's Britannia Brown now over to English. English will pull up the three. That's good. Nothing but net from Brittany English with the deep three.
There, it finally draws from English. She was chucking up a few from beyond the arc there and was having trouble getting them to drop, but she'll get that one to go.
Al-Najjar with it now. Going strong, and she'll get fouled. She goes down.
Yeah, Jamie Gordon, not the easiest player to drive against, and she put Najjar to the floor there.
That's Gordon's second foul. Team foul number five, so Hawks in the penalty. UTM with only one team foul so far in the fourth. 3:22 to go. As Al-Najjar misses the first one.
And as this one's winding up, the Hawks sit at 71 points. Worth mentioning, they have scored 80-plus in four straight. I'm sure head coach A.J. Sharma is not too concerned about running up the score anymore, but interesting stat to keep your eye on as they look for their fifth straight 80-plus night.
That one no good. We're on the second attempt, so 0-2 from the line from Al-Najjar.
And this blowout is winding down now, 3:18 on the clock.
Just a reminder that the men's game is coming up right after this, scheduled for about 30 minutes from now. Hawks versus UTM as well.
There's a big block off the hand of Victoria Silva.
Here's Viado going strong on Brown and stepping out of bounds is Janella Viado.
Working her way to the baseline, a little too far to the baseline there, and that'll concede possession.
Just under 3 minutes to go in this one. Hawks lead 71-24, intercepted pass there from Adai, and she'll put, just misses that one. And she's gonna get charged for the foul, so she misses the free layup and gets charged for the foul. Not the best possession there.
Yeah, give her a lot of credit for jumping that pass there. It seems like she read the mind of the player there, and about the most wide open look she's had all night and can't get it to go. And to make matters worse, she had to deal with Jamie Gordon under the rim.
Here's Anang trying to find Gordon, intercepted there from El Najar, who'll find Viado. Viado thinking about a three, she puts it up, off the mark, rebound. Britannia Brown back the other way. Anang lost it for a second, just gets it back before it goes out.
Brown English now on the far side, wide open, there she is.
There she is, here's the three, no good, off the mark. Rebound, great play from English going up and trying to intercept that pass. And it will be UTM ball, but great effort there from English.
Yeah, English standing just 5'6", but she sure got a long ways up there to deflect that pass back.
English with 16 points on this night.
What a showcase for her it's been, showing what she could do on the offensive and defensive side of the floor. She may have earned herself some more playing time.
And she came into this game with only 3.8 points per game averaging this season, so she's been on a great performance here tonight. Jada Dye hits double digits with 10 after that bucket.
Yeah, for a lot of these players, it just comes down to opportunity. Everyone's really produced tonight, given a chance, and that's positive to see as there's a foul drawn.
And Jamie Gordon gonna get called for the Eagle screen there. And you talked about the opportunity that these players that maybe don't get enough playing time that maybe they deserve in their minds. Girl like Brittany English playing really well, and Nang also doing really well on the defensive side of the ball as well.
Yeah, see, take a look at that last foul there by English, and that's been one of her few mistakes tonight, as she's been pretty good in everything she's done, especially distributing the basketball. Plenty of assists racked up.
Evelyn Anang with 4 points, but she's been good on the defensive side of the ball as well.
Yeah, each and every Hawk that touched the floor tonight really has contributed, mostly on the defensive side of things, obviously holding the Eagles to just 27 points.
A much better second half performance here from the Eagles after only putting up 6 in that first half. They've come back with 22 in the second.
Yeah, if they had this type of play in the first quarter, it could have been a different story here late in the fourth, but that hole was just far too big, and they couldn't find a ladder tall enough.
English here, 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Good move from Anang. Puts it up with the left hand. Intercepted there from Brown, and that's an easy bucket for her.
That scoreboard rising up to 75 is two quick buckets there. Britannia Brown not backing off that inbound with this lead.
An easy bucket there for Brown after a great defensive play. A three here, that's off the mark. Gordon comes down with the rebound.
Good work by Gordon to make that a tough look.
1 minute to go. Brown over to English. Looking for three, finds Gordon wide open. She can't finish it. Rebound, she gets it back, trying to find someone open. She'll go up instead. That's off the mark, rebound Eagles. And Jamie Gordon missing a couple buckets there, but good effort.
Yeah, she did everything right there except put it in the basket. It's two strong rebounds there, showing she's a force under that basket.
Yeah, came up with her own rebound too, just missed that second one as well. 30 seconds to go in this one. Here's a die. Pivoting that foot.
And this defense hasn't changed since the first whistle. Nothing easy. Yeah,
going up there. And she'll get foul. Jamie Gordon on the call. That's her fourth of the game here. But these free throws should finish off this one. 75-28 is the score.
With yeah, this one was all but over at halftime, I would say. The Eagles putting up just 6 points at the half. And good showing by them to rack it up to 28 here late. But just too little too late The Hawks have dominated every single part of the floor.
Yeah, really dominant performance from the Hawks. You said it on both sides of the ball, defensively and offensively, as English here carries it through. The shot clock is off, 15 seconds to go, and English trying to dribble out here. Still pressuring are the Eagles. Ebony Beals.
Give credit to the Eagles playing tough until the very end, but tonight was not their night.
But the Hawks will pick up their 11th win in a row after dropping their first of the season versus Fanshawe. They've been perfect ever since on an 11-game win streak as they win this one 75-29. UTM, they drop to 4-9, and their losing streak of 9 in a row continues as both streaks will continue here today.
Yeah, it's easy to look at the final score, see this blowout, and kind of sweep it under the rug and dismiss it and forget all about it. But for head coach AJ Sharma, you got the number 2 nationally ranked team coming up on your schedule on Sunday. So I'm sure he treated this as a major warm-up for that game. So they may have been running up the score just a tad, but with Fanshawe coming up, you want to get every opportunity.
Yeah, it was a great win for the Hawks. They win this one 75-29 in a great performance from the Hawks defense and offensively. As you can see on your board, 75-29, an absolute dominant victory for them on both sides of the floor.
Yeah, that's about as good as you're gonna see a performance from AJ Sharma and his team, as they now look ahead on that schedule circled in a bright red Sharpie, I'm sure, as that Fanshawe date is, they're looking for redemption.
UTM will go on a 3-game road trip here starting today. They'll have 2 more games against St. Clair and Lambton on that 2-game road trip. Humber, on the other hand, will play Fanshawe on Sunday, which will be a great one on Sunday afternoon with the player of the game, Danielle Dupuy, on the sidelines.
Hi, and welcome to the sideline. My name's Danielle Dupuy, and I'm here with player of the game, Brittany English. Congratulations out there. How'd it feel?
It was good, you know, very tiring.
I'm tired. So we know that next week you guys are going up against Fanshawe. How do you feel about that? I mean, beginning of the season wasn't your best game, and now going into it, what are the thoughts?
You know, in the beginning of the season, a lot of our players are injured. But, you know, this game coming Sunday is all about habits. You know, you can't really make a mistake with that type of team. They've been our rival for a minute. So everyone's just going to have to play their heart out and do what we got to do.
Well, good job today. We wish you luck on Sunday. Back to you guys. Thank you.
Thanks, Danielle. And Brittany said she was tired, and she led her team with 27 minutes and 16 points, 9 rebounds, and 11 assists, a double-double for Brittany English.
What a great, honest interview that is. She's tired. I don't blame her. That was a heck of a performance by her. And as she mentioned, that big date coming up on Sunday.
And the men's game is coming up right after this. Thanks for watching. My name is Kyle Dolph, my broadcast partner, Adam Lusher. Danielle Dupuy on the sidelines. Thanks for watching. Men's game coming up next.